A Florida Republican congressman and Army combat veteran now says he supports a ban on future purchases of AR-15 style weapons, assault weapons. His powerful piece in the New York Times opinion page is headlined, "I'm Republican, I appreciate assault weapons, and I support a ban." Congressman Brian Mast joins us now. Congressman, thank you so much for being with us. It's an interesting discussion. Why this change of heart? Why now?
Look, when I was on the battlefield and I saw an opportunity to save a life, I didn't have a conversation about it. I acted. That's the way we do it on the battlefield. That's what makes sense. It's common sense, and that's what needs to happen here.
So you're saying that banning AR-15 weapons is a chance to save a life?
I believe that. That's why I came out and said this. You know, I look at the platform that I carried, an M4 carbine, very similar to an AR-15. I was carrying that weapon on the battlefield in the most dangerous country on earth for one reason, because of its lethality. It was the best weapon that the Army could give me to go out there and make sure that I could eliminate our enemies. I can honestly say that my community and my kids in our schools, I don't think that they're made safer by the general population of civilians having unfettered access to the best weapon the Army could put in my hand to go out there and kill our enemies.
Your colleagues asked the question, though, why take this out of responsible gun owners' hands? Why take this from the well-trained, adept gun users who obey the law and want to use an AR-15-style weapon for target practice?
I love the well-trained gun owner, the responsible gun owner. I am one. I'm a rabid concealed carry guy. I usually carry a 9mm, and I think that's one of the most important points about this. I carry a 9mm because I don't want to die because of a lack of shooting back one day. That's why I carry one. But I can go out there and look at this honestly as a person that's done threat assessment and say, you know what, if somebody's coming after me with an AR-15, maximum effective range of easily 300 meters, certainly a great range of 50 to 150 meters, my max range with my 9mm, maybe 20, 25 meters, you know, maybe probably not 30 meters on a good day, I'm not going to have that opportunity to defend myself. And, you know, so it's just in that I think it's a common sense approach, because we're not concealing and carrying AR-15s.
You know, the Supreme Court has said that, yes, you know, Americans have the right to bear arms, but not the right to bear any and all arms. What do you mean?
And, you know, I think that's an important point. We don't have unlimited access to the automatic weapons that I carried on the battlefield. I can't go out there and get a SAW automatic weapon. I can't go out there and get hand grenades or an AT-4 rocket launcher or a LAW rocket. These are things that I can't get. We respect that the Second Amendment is a God-given right. That right to defend ourselves, it's unimpeachable, but it doesn't mean every single arm.
Let me ask you very quickly on Florida Governor Rick Scott and also this debate at the national level about raising the minimum age you can purchase really all firearms to 21. Do you support that?
I will absolutely support raising that age. I mean, I think there's a lot of things that we can do, whether it's looking at add-ons that go onto weapons that try to circumvent the law for things that, you know, we're not supposed to have automatic weapons, that being a ban, whether we're looking at all of the things relating to mental illness. And, you know, here in Florida, we have the Baker Act, but you can get Baker Acted for, you know, saying that you want to, voices are telling you to kill people. And then right after you get out of your 72-hour confinement, they're going to hand you your weapons back. That's a very serious issue. We got to look at all of the failures that exist with the, you know, existed with the FBI and all of the things at the local level. You have to look at school security and making sure, you know, in my schools here in Martin County, Florida, where I'm sitting right now, they know that I'm Congressman Brian Mast. But when I walk up to the window in their office, they still make me show a piece of identification before they let me in the door. We can't be letting people just walk in. And, you know, there's a lot of things beyond that we can do, but I'm going to be supporting, you know, these measures if that means that we can save a life. I'm never going to regret saving a life.
Congressman Mast, thank you for joining us tonight. Thank you for your service. Appreciate it.